How do the Knights decide on programming or repertoire for these upcoming concerts and tours that you have?
Well, the Knights have many different organizations within the orchestra, or groups, or work groups, committees, and one of them is a programming committee. My brother and I are on that committee, and we feel like that's so much of what we do with the group, is find the type of interesting programming that we can understand and therefore can translate, and therefore an audience can receive it confidently. Mm-hmm. And that is one of our biggest goals. The thought is, if we have a program that we're performing and everyone on stage knows why these pieces go together, even if it's not talked about to an audience, or if it's talked about with an audience, of course, but if it's not, you could feel it's tangible when musicians are playing, that they have a concept of an arc of a show. And that translates to an audience. And therefore, you know, maybe there's just a few more people in that audience that are going to take one more step and go and think about another composer and be excited about a composer. Why Morton Feldman has been one of the biggest, like, pulls. Like, so many people said, oh, that Morton Feldman piece is so great. Well, it's because of where we put it on a concert, I think, and how it fits onto an overall evening of music.
Do you welcome feedback from your players and ideas from your players?
Absolutely. There's all, I mean, with any part of the organization, it's an open door. Everyone can contribute ideas, thoughts, feedback, any type of communication. And with programming, so many things do happen. Oh, I had this amazing idea. I heard this piece and this thing was on my iPad and I put it together. Wow, what if? And then things build that way. Mm-hmm. We also, you know, program depending on what soloists we want to work with and what type of project we want to build.